In this video, I will show you how you can turn this baby bug zapper, which has hardly 2 kilovolts, it's not powerful, you can see, into this monster taser gun. It has 20 kilovolts, so let's start. You can find this bug zapper in your home, which is pretty cheap and popular in the market. It can output max to max 3000 volt. We can tell this by measuring its arc, which is hardly an mm. And I need something more powerful and exciting to play with. So I opened one which I had lying around, and inside it I found this circuit. Your circuit can maybe slightly different from mine, because it all depends on the seller. I mean, the manufacturer. Here I got a switch and a push button and some diode, resistors and capacitors. This circuit was not working because the battery was dead, so I replaced it with a 4 volt lead acid battery, and it's working now. I can revive this battery by some distilled water and use it in my future projects, or in this project maybe. And after turning on the switch, I am getting expected arcs, 3 kilovolts maybe. It's pretty decent, but I want more. Hear the arcs carefully. You will need it to compare it to our upgrade. After analyzing the circuit, this circuit has 1 capacitor, some resistors and 4 diodes, which are full bridge rectifier to rudely charge the 4 volt lead acid battery. You don't need transformer, man. Just spend in that, your battery will be saved. The first thing I did was to remove all the unnecessary things on the circuit. And the circuit looks pretty clean and small. And these are the fucking components I got. Some diodes, resistors and blah blah blah. I will not use this to charge my battery. It will harm my battery. And then after removing it, I cut the circuit because it's unnecessary to use that much space. Still making sure that the circuit is working. Let's see if it is working. Pray for me. The PCB traces were all visible, so it was easy for me to see how the connections are made for each component. And yeah, the circuit is still working. Other people should have done this.
Maybe they don't know how the circuit works. And there was also a high voltage capacitor, 2000 volts maybe. And I had one lying around from my old mosquito bat, so I thought I could use it. Just connecting them in parallel increases the capacitance. And the second thing I did was to connect them in parallel to increase their capacitance so that they can store more high voltages. Let's see if it made any difference. Powering it with the same 4 volt lead acid battery to the same terminal and hoping for the best. Yeah, it's definitely stronger. Just ignore the background noise. And after it, I drilled the hole on the PCB to insert my cute little push button, which I extracted from this. I don't want to remove this. It's too cute. I don't want to remove it. And after it, I soldered the battery connections, I mean the battery terminals, to the button. Yellow is for positive and green is for negative. And I am damn sure about it that you will not find this cute little push button in any of the market or online store. And don't skip the video, I will explain how the circuit works. And the third thing I did was to connect more power. Connected the revived battery in series. It's total 8 volts and 1.5 ampere, I guess. So let's turn on the circuit. You can see that I don't have to touch the terminals now. It's arcing from huge distances. I love this, man. And after this, I decided to remove the high voltage wire with nails, because in case you will need to pierce through anyone's body to go the high voltage in the bloods and kill him. Lol.
No,
don't do it. It just revived my battery, so I don't want to put load on it. So I'm using my buck boost converter. Damn!
Blood is coming out of my ears. What the fuck is going on? It's thunder loud. Zoomed a little bit. Maybe now you can see? I don't know. Is it dead? Was that an internal arcing which damaged my components? Nice, it's still working. Here is a tough guy I made. And here I just exploded my capacitor's outer layer due to high power corona discharge. It's not COVID-19. It's named earlier than COVID-19 virus. But it's still working. You want to know how the circuit works? Let me explain it to you. When we push the power button, the circuit turns on. The battery voltage is fed to this high voltage switching transistors, which converts the DC voltage to AC because transformers don't work in DC voltage. Then the transformer step ups the voltage. Then it is further step up by this Cockcroft voltage generator, this capacitor and diode circuit. And this it is fed to this capacitor to store the high voltage. Then the capacitor bangs. Bahut chutiya apa kar liya aaj ke liye. Bye.